baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex.
All right.
Let's talk about sex.
Sexiling would be when your roommate asks you to leave the room when he's going to have sex. I mean, I've never personally experienced it, so I can't say for sure, but that'd probably be the best way.
I define sexiling as being kicked out of your room for your roommate to, you know,
oh, not practicing,
go have some fun.
Practicing being in front of
people. Kicking someone out of their room for any period of time to, so they can, like, get it on.
Okay.
A significant other.
Is when asks you to leave the room temporarily or for an extended period of time so that you can enjoy the company of another person.
Urban Dictionary defines sexiling as banishing a roommate from the room, dorm, or apartment for the purpose of engaging in intimate relations with one significant other or sex partner. Have you ever been sexiled or been the one to sexile?
My roommates and I have sort of a mutual agreement. You know, we just send each other texts like, "Hey, I'd like some alone time," and it's you can do whatever you want with that alone time. Put it that way.
I've had more problems with my roommate's boyfriend staying over every single weekend since the beginning of the year, and B, like, two times I was kicked out for the whole night.
In general, it doesn't happen to me often, so it doesn't really bug me.
How frequently would you say it occurs?
That's a really good question. I think it occurs more often than we realize, but I can't really think of a number.
Probably pretty often. I've heard a lot of people who've had the similar problems with
this. I think sexiling occurs every Friday, Saturday, and sometimes on Thursday.
Generally, colleges have not made this illegal. In fact, in 2009, Tufts University issued a statement practically encouraging sexiling, stating that students should please refrain from having sex with a roommate present in the room. According to most colleges like Penn State and St. Mary's, the roommates determine their own limitations at their college. Even most Christian and religious schools have not yet set certain policies regarding this sexiling, although certain universities, like Liberty and Flagler University, have policies that do not allow opposite genders in residence halls. Some residence halls, like those at Grove City, are segregated by gender to decrease the likelihood of this occurring, although this is not always effective. Penn State does not have a policy regarding opposite genders in dorms or living spaces. What are your personal views regarding sexiling?
You know, I mean, there's times where I'd say it's a little inconsiderate, but I think if you and your roommate talk about it beforehand and not just you show up with a girl and be like, "Hey, dude, leave." You know, if it's something you know it's going to happen, or you have a steady girlfriend or something that comes over, you know, as long as you have you can have a comfortable conversation with your roommate to address it, like men, then, you know, I think it's something that can be properly dealt with and handled.
It's how you feel about it and how your relationship is with your roommate and what you guys discussed. Definitely rather no, so I don't, like, walk into anything, but I mean, it's gonna happen.
I think no matter what, even if you're, like, friends with your roommate and you're on the same page with it, it's always disrespectful. I mean, you paid a lot of money for that room, but, and just, like, not being able to use it for, even for, like, half an hour, I mean, it is sort of, like, uncomfortable unless you're, like, already gone off doing something. But at the same time, it's normal. So, it's not anything outrageous, I feel.
I honestly have no problem with it. Everybody needs their space, their time, their privacy. So, I don't have a positive or particularly negative view of sexiling because, you know, we live in cramped dorms and everybody needs some privacy.
According to Penn State's housing policy, all students are allowed to have visitors as long as they stay no longer than 3 days and are approved by all of the students' roommates. Guests can be of either gender. This is the only rule that Penn State has with association to sexiling. There is no explicit rule forbidding it. We sat down with the residence life coordinator to talk about Penn State's current policy regarding sexiling.
With any roommate conflict, we sit down with both parties, you know, and kind of mediate through that. So, you know, just talking about it usually solves it. You know, we don't move people right away. We try to, you know, work through things because just, you know, brushing the issue aside is going to come up again later in life. So, you know, address the issues that you have with your roommate. So usually talking about it works.
And would you support any policy to discourage something specifically to members of the opposite gender?
Well, I can't really speak on that. I mean, any stuff with the housing contract has to kind of go through a lot of different rules. So something on that would go through a whole process of getting approved. And I don't know, you know, where Penn State would go with that.
Would you support any policy to discourage sexiling?
I don't know if I would support a policy in the housing contract because I think that's just like getting too much into your personal life. I think it should rather just stay between you and your roommate and how you guys feel about it. I definitely think it should stay a social thing. I don't think the university should really have a say.
We have policies, you know, for alcohol and noise, and I mean, we have them all for a reason. I think it would be a tough one to uphold. Not that I have any issue upholding any of the policies, but it's one of those you can't tell someone they can't have sex.
I know that in the contract, technically, you're not supposed to have any visitors for longer than 3 days, and then after you have for like a week, and after you have to wait 8 days after their last day for them to come back. And that's not really enforced, so I don't really think any sexiling policy would be enforced. Just one of those things that's not the most important thing on Penn State housing.
I wouldn't say that there's been too many issues with that, so I think right now just talking to one another solves a lot in terms of guest policies and getting into arguments that way. If you have guests.
Like the way housing has set up its policies where it bans everything that's illegal and everything dangerous, and sex is neither of those, so I think it should remain a social contract amongst